weigh on the performance of judicial officers, this is not the only area which we are required to address. Performance on the judicial side and administrative side have their own implications and difficulties to fix a benchmark. On the judicial side, performance indicators will change depending on dependency, nature of work, cooperation, knowledge of the local bar, whereas administrative indicators will depend upon the capacity of staff, local issues, etc. We are in the process of striking a balance between the performance parameters of judicial and administrative areas. I earnestly feel that this conference gave a great opportunity to the administration to review the working of subordinate courts, identify the areas which need improvement and find solution to bridge the gap between expectations and performance. Keeping the theme of the conference in view, we selected topics for discussion and to deliberate in four academic sessions. The primary aim was to evaluate our performance, critically exploring the shortcomings in the system in meeting demands and expectations, and to focus on management of cases and courts. As to how best we can design our future course of action in the context of elevating the prestige and honor of the judicial institution. I will not repeat what were the subjects discussed, but I would not like to, dilate or state what was discussed in each working session. What was the consensus reached, since we have on the dais my esteemed brothers who were co-chairpersons in the working sessions, and have been requested to give resume of every working session for 5 minutes only. In all technical sessions, apart from hearing the informative and thought-provoking speeches of the resource persons, the judicial officers got their doubt cleared and made their valuable suggestions for the improvement in the working of courts at all levels, which, as a leader of the team, I assure all, would be taken note of. I would like to further add that participation of judicial officers was excellent and the deliberations were meaningful. I am sure this conference has enriched all judicial officers in every respect, and it will go a long way in improving their working in the state of Uttar Pradesh. But let me state few words about the first working session on exercise of judicial discretion in interlocutory orders and bail applications by district judiciary. Yesterday I highlighted the unjustified reluctance on the part of members of the district judiciary to consider the grant of routine bail and interim orders of protection. The manner and pace with which the interlocutory applications and the bail applications are handled by the courts have a significant bearing on the outcome of the substantive suit and criminal trials in which such applications are made. We have noticed judges hesitate in passing discretionary orders, maybe for known or unknown fear. In this working session, my brother judges who were on the panel have drawn the attention of you all to the dynamics of discretionary jurisprudence in disposal of interlocutory applications. If the advice given by them is followed, I am sure the High Court would not have to chastise the trial courts for their inability to effectively adjudicate upon interlocutory applications. If there is a proper exercise of discretion and the speaking orders are passed purely on merits and in accordance with law, you need not carry any fear in mind, and I'm sure that will go a long way in reducing your burden and also burden of the High Court. Dear friends, I'm sure you all will go back with great memories of this conference. When I say so, what I mean is to remember that the litigating public in the state demands speedy and timely justice, not only in civil but even in criminal trials pending in different courts. From the point of view of the accused also, the right to speedy trial is a fundamental right. As we all know, numerous persons comment and criticize the courts as a reason for delay. Setting this criticism aside, the need of the hour for all of us is to focus our attention on speedy and timely justice in every case, maybe by trying and deciding the case on merits or disposing it off through mediation or any other alternative dispute resolution mode. My request to the judicial officers is to carry message that they have received from Honorable Supreme Court judges and resource persons and implement them in their courts so that objective of the conference would stand fulfilled. I assure Honorable the Chief Justice of India and other judges of the Supreme Court that all stakeholders that we shall endeavor to be counted amongst first three high courts working to promote judicial values as envisaged under our constitution and to meet expectations of modern India. While confident in our resolve to achieve the promises made here today, we assure that we shall not let overconfidence and complacency deter us or make us falter in our resolve. I request Honorable Mr. Justice A.K. Sikri to convey our feelings to Honorable the Chief Justice of India and his other colleagues. I request all judicial officers in the state of Uttar Pradesh to solemnly promise that they would work together in making the judicial institution of this great state to gain even greater luster by their contribution. As you all know, this is the first state-level district judges and additional district judges conference of its kind. This, I am sure, is a good beginning. Before we part, let me inform you all, we have decided that in future there shall be a district judges conference annually, and once in a 3 years, there will be a conference of this magnitude in the state of Uttar Pradesh. In the next judicial officers conference of this nature, perhaps some of us would not be there, but the show must go on. My Lord Justice Sikri is known as a voracious reader and one of the best orators in the country. I would not like to stand any further between you and him, whom we are all eager to hear for long. I shall only take this opportunity before I sit down to quickly place on record my gratitude to all persons who were involved in organization of this conference. The arrangements for holding this conference were made by organizing committee under the able guidance of Brother Justice Tarun Agarwal and with the hard work of my brother and sister judges at Lucknow and the office officers and staff of registry. I also take this opportunity to convey my sincere thanks to my brother and sister judges who were involved in the organization of this conference. Without their tireless efforts, this mammoth conference would have never become a reality. I also place on record my heartfelt thanks and sincere appreciation to the members of the editorial committee who have prepared and collated the handbook in 2 volumes provided to all participants. The handbook will, I am sure, act as a guide to all judicial officers on important subjects digested therein and also enable them to ponder upon the views expressed in various articles included in the same. I am grateful also to all who have contributed to the handbook for having spared their valuable time in preparing the articles on varied subjects and sharing their knowledge and experience amongst the judicial officers of the state. Last but not least, my heartfelt gratitude and thanks goes out to all members of the staff, Registrar General and the team of registrars, the registry, my personal staff, other members of the registry, but for whose untiring and relentless efforts this conference would not have taken shape. I express my gratitude to the government of Uttar Pradesh for supporting the state judiciary in a big way. I request for their continuous support for smooth and efficient functioning of the judiciary by resolving issues pending with them early. I also express my deep sense of gratitude to Honorable Mr. Justice Deepak Mishra, the Chief Justice of India, who, as a chairman of NALSA, as he then was, allowed us to postpone the National Lok Adalat, which was scheduled today, to 17th of this month to enable us to hold this conference. I appeal to you all to make the National Lok Adalat on next Sunday a grand success. I look forward to the cooperation from all quarters in accomplishing the task and to keep our state's judiciary ahead of all other institutions of governance. Before concluding my remarks, I remind you of what Lord Macaulay stated 150 years ago. I quote, "My principle is simply this, uniformity when you can have it, diversity when you must have it, in all cases, certainty." Thank you once again. And I wish you all the best.